Well, I think there's a couple of things that's really important that all of us do, whether you're a consumer or a producer, you know, if you have any connection whatsoever. I think the first thing is you have to educate yourself, educate your peers, educate your consumers, and do that constantly, and make sure you're relying on sources of information that are grounded in some sort of evidence or some sort of science. You know, have a high bar for what you consider to be evidence and what you consider to be the truth. I think that's an important thing, not only in sense of protecting ourselves, but also making sure that the truth is likely to spread faster than some of the misinformation, which is something we battle all the time. I think it's important to remember that, you know, we're educating others even when we don't think we are. So we have to be very careful that our public messages about antimicrobial stewardship are backed up by action on the farm, and they're backed up by investment in preventive activities, and that we're working to make sure we're walking the same talk that we're talking all the time. And I think we have to have just a complete and utter intolerance for misinformation, right? You know, we're getting ready to go into Thanksgiving, and I just foresee some family discussion is going to eventually get to antibiotics and vaccines, and I'm going to have to bite through my bottom lip to preserve domestic tranquility. But, you know, I feel like at times we still have an obligation to sort of set the record straight sometimes, even in those settings. So